like a winner, man.
I will praise you, Lord, for your grace on my life. You have blessed me, your Father, no one dance like a winner,
oh,
man.
I will praise you, Lord, for your grace on my life. You have blessed me, your Father, now I dance like a winner, man.
I will praise you, Lord, for your grace on my life. You have blessed me, your Father, now I dance like a winner, man.
So, when you see me dance, I dance like a winner. Come on, sir. You run, you run, you run.
Yes, let me hear you saying that the Lord is good all the time. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Father God, we give you the praise. There is no one like you. Nobody can compare to you, Father God. You are all wonderful, powerful, marvelous, all above all, hallelujah. Child of God, are you here? Halakoba Yeshi Kabi Randa Bayasanda Barada Bayasanda. Welcome to our church service. Hallelujah. Welcome to our church service. Yes, welcome, welcome. Louise Azu, welcome. Anta Mireille, you are welcome. Hallelujah. In our live service, Rose Blanche, you are welcome. Hallelujah. Evangelist Maka Boisi, you are welcome on our live service. Ida Labaron, welcome in our live service of Sunday, day 17th of May. Hallelujah. God is good. And all the time, God is good. Hallelujah. I want you to share. Come on now. Share, share, share. Hallelujah. God is good. Hallelujah. I need your answer there in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you for those who have already started sharing. Hallelujah. Raka baya sendebo rendebori adabaya sanda. Share our live program. Our live program in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord. Lord, we give you the praise. There is no one like you. Father God, we exalt you. We lift you up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Zeke baya sanda baya shende. Bobo, yes, somebody in here this afternoon is about to actually experience the marvelous and wonderful flow of God in their life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. If you believe, your amen, your amen will be enough to secure it. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Zeka baya sanda. Yeah, that's it. Come on now. Let's share. Let's share. Do not waste any time. Let's share. Let's share. We only got 3 shares so far. Hallelujah. We can do more than that. Hallelujah. Come on now. Let's share. Let's share in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Raka baya sendebo. Rendebo yasika bari di beye sente. Raka rada baya sanda. Rendebo boyo soto. Hallelujah. Come on, come on, come on. Child of God, share. Because somebody is about to be blessed this afternoon, and you want to be responsible for this blessing. Hallelujah. Because as you share, let me tell you something, you are opening up the door of blessing in your own life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let somebody share our video in Jesus' mighty name. Rake bayo sikaba landebo riyadaba yasanda rendebo 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 risakaba yashanda rendebo kosikaba radaba yasandebe. Somebody share our video. Come on, come on, let's do it. Hallelujah. Rose ke baya shanta. Rede bayo sekere. Randa baba baya sanda. Yes, 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 yes. Hallelujah. Yes, Lecoq MMO, welcome, welcome. Welcome, Cynthia. Welcome, Cynthia. Say, anyone that you don't see here, mention their name. Hallelujah. Mention their name. Hallelujah. Zakebo le karanda baya sanda. Rinde beko sika barada baya sanda. Mention their name. Mention their name so that they can start following us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father God, we give you the praise. There is no one like you. No one like you. Raka baya sanda. Rende bobo yoso ki barada bayasa. Rende beke shete boyasada. If there is any blessing coming from heaven to earth today, let you be the person who will receive that breakthrough, that blessing, that solution in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So hallelujah. Shalom, shalom, Cornel Melchizedek. You are blessed in the mighty name of Jesus. Come on, guys. Let's share. Let's share. You know, share it on your page. Do not be. Do not Do not say to yourself, what will my friend say or what will my followers say? You know, if you're feeling free, so do so. Share it on your own page, on your own profile. Share it in your WhatsApp group. Hallelujah. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we give you the praise. There is no one like you. Hallelujah. Somebody in here, you see, the Lord is telling me that it looks like there is a stop at the river that was flowing in your way, that was flowing. You know, you thought that you had everything figured out, but now you just discover that it looks like something is stuck, it's not working. But I gotta tell you something, my dear, I got good news for you. Hallelujah. Yes, with man it can be stopped, with people it can be stopped, with whatever you can see and materials it can be stopped, but with God, what is stopped with man still working with God. Come on, look at here. The Bible says somewhere there in the book of Genesis that everything was stopped with Sarah. Are you hearing me? Everything was stopped with Sarah. But you see, God wasn't stopped. God could carry on. God could move on. And whatever was stopped in the life of what? Of Sarah, Abraham's wife, God made it move. Hallelujah. With God, there is no limitation. With God, there is no impossibility. With God, there is no negativity. So I'm talking to somebody in here, and I just want to let you know the favor of God is on your way in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Come on, guys. We can invite people. We can let them know that we are here and we are live. Our service is live in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we give you the praise. There is no one like you. I pray for you. Answer me right for all these people you are sharing the connection to. I pray for you. Yeah, let God carry on elevating you in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray for you, Louise Azu. I pray for you, Lecoq MMO. I pray for you, Mama Hélène Cousseau. I pray for you, Ida La Baronne. I pray for you, for those of you sharing and viewing our broadcast right now. Let the favor of God locate you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I am going to share as well. There are people that are relying on this broadcast. So let me, share to them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Zekobaya Sanda Baba Rande Boboko Sika Borane Boye Sende Riada Baba Yasanda Rende Boko Soke Baya Sanda. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father, we give you the praise. There is no one like you, nobody like you. Hallelujah. You are unique in your ways. Hallelujah. Rakabaya Sende Bo Riada Baba Yasande Boboko Soto. Whatever negativity that was heading towards you, I break it, I destroy it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Whatever negativity, whatever impossibility which was heading towards you, I say I break it by fire, by thunder, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Receive it, your amen, get it, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, your hand of favor in the name of Jesus, in the life of your people. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Rebabaya Sanda, Roko Soko Bako Se, Ri Adebobaya Sanda. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Somebody in here about to receive a breakthrough. Just claim it and receive it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we give you the praise. There is no one like you. There is no one like you. There is no one like you. You have shown yourself strong in the life of Jeremiah. I pray this very moment that you show yourself strong in the life of Lecoq MMO. I pray this moment that you show yourself stronger in the life of Mirai, in the life of those that I can't see yet, in the life of Evangelist Makabwazi. I pray that you show yourself strong in her house, in her relationship, in the lives of the children, in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for all of you, all the members. Yes, Cynthia, I pray for you. Cynthia, see, I pray right now, let God show himself strong in your situation. Let your enemies, your adversaries, let those who oppose you see the hand of God in your life, see the favor of God in your life. I pray for you, Living Word. Let my God put a testimony in your mouth in the name of Jesus. Let the favor of God touch your husband in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I pray for your household, anybody with a housing issue. I pray, let my God locate you wherever you are right now. Let the favor of God locate you. Hallelujah. You are the head and not the tail. You are above and not beneath. You are the first and not the last. You are the salt of the earth. You are the light of the world. And I gotta tell you something. My God is blessing you in the field. My God is blessing you in the village. My God is blessing you in the town. Hallelujah. Whatever you set your hands on, success shall be the outcome. That's why your business shall succeed. Are you hearing? Come on now. I'm starting with proclamation. I'm starting with blessing. I'm starting with prophecies. Hallelujah. My God shall locate you. And whatever you set your hands on, I don't know what it is. Many people have tried. It did not work for them. Many people tried. It did not go ahead for them. But you, as a child of God, whatever you put your hands on, whatever you set your hand on, the breakthrough shall be the outcome. Success shall be the outcome. Breakthrough shall be the outcome. In the name of Jesus Christ. If that's you, say, I receive it. Come on now, let me hear you. Say, I receive it. While you are doing that, I want you to share, because our share level is not enough here. Hallelujah. We can do it. Come on now, let's share this broadcast. Let's share this broadcast to touch people. Hallelujah. This is, you know, as we are sharing, you know, it is like we are sowing in the house of God. Hallelujah. When we sow finances, when we sow, when we give, when we do all this, it is also the same as when you are sharing the gospel. It is like you standing in the middle of the road and you are talking about God, and you are letting them know that there is a God who is able to answer all. There is a God in heaven who is able to make way where there is no way. There is a God in heaven who is able to open the gate which has been closed by the enemy. There is a God in heaven who is able to shut down every door and windows of the devil in your life. There is a God in heaven who will answer your questions, who will answer your situation, who will give you the solution where that solution is needed. Somebody is hearing me this afternoon. My God is starting a new come on now. Can I say that? I just receive it straight away. My God is starting a new chapter with you. Are you hearing what I'm saying here? The old chapter is gone. The old chapter is gone. God is working on a new chapter. He's starting a new chapter with you. And I'm talking about not tomorrow. I said from today, Papa God is starting a new chapter in your situation. If that's you, say, I receive it. Yes, come on now. We need to carry on inviting. We want to be able to reach a higher number of people, you know, watching the broadcast. Hallelujah. In so doing, we are actually giving out the gospel, the good news to people, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Can somebody hear me here this afternoon? Roke baya sande boko soto. Hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise. We give you the adoration in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I want you to go with me in the Bible. Hallelujah. I want you to go with me in the Bible, in the book of Philippians. Take your Bible. Let's go in the book of Philippians. Hallelujah. Sakabaya sende boko rede boke shita ran. Where I need to update my Bible here in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So Father, we give you the praise. There is no one like you. Hallelujah. Let's go in the Bible, in the book of Philippians chapter 1 verse 6. Let's go in there. Philippians chapter 1 verse 6. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let me see if I can grab it here, if it's updated. Hallelujah. Ramba baya sende bo rea de boke sanda. Rinda babaya sende bobo rende boke sika baya sanda. Hallelujah. God is good. And all the time he is good. Philippians chapter 1 verse 6. The Bible says, being confident of this very thing, that he which had begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. He who has begun the good work in you will perform it to the day of Jesus Christ. You know, the part of the verse that I would like to talk about this afternoon. He who has begun the good work in you. He who has begun the good thing in you. He who has begun to do, open good doors in you, will carry on, will not stop. Hallelujah. The God who has started doing good to you, that God will not stop. Nothing can make the God who has started doing good in your life, nothing can make him stop. Now, let me tell you something. Nothing made him start in the first place. So therefore, nothing can make him stop. Nothing can stop that God. The God who has begun the good work in your life will carry on. No matter what the devil is saying, no matter what the enemies are saying, no matter what the adversaries are saying, that God who has begun the good work in your life will carry on to the fulfillment in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Are you here this afternoon? God is good. God is good. God is good. Somebody say all the time, hallelujah. God is good. Robaya Sande Boboko Soto. Hallelujah. May the blessing of God locate you wherever you are right now in Jesus' mighty name. And today, let me tell you, you are going to leave the service when we finish, you will leave the service not the way you came in. You will leave the service fully blended, fully anointed, fully blessed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. May the favor of God form a force field around you. May the favor of God secure your location. May the favor of God visit you. May the favor of God bring success at your doorstep in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father, we give you the praise. There is no one like you. Nobody can compare with you. In Jesus' mighty name, are you here this afternoon? Yes, while you are watching, you need to keep on sharing so we can go through the roof, hallelujah, with our viewers, hallelujah. So you got to keep on sharing in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, hallelujah. Many believers are defeated, hallelujah, not because the devil is powerful, but because they don't have the zeal to resist the challenges of Satan. They do not have the zeal to resist the challenges that life is bringing upon them. Many believers are defeated because they were not able to withstand the blow of the enemy. Are you hearing what I'm saying here? Many Christians lost their battle not because God rejected them, but just because they gave up on the way before their destination. They gave up on the way. They got off the bus. The bus was going from point A to point C. But when they got to point B, because of all the problems, they got off before they reached their destination. Many good relationships ended because partners were not able to keep up their stand for long. They were not able to keep up their stand for long. Are you hearing me this afternoon? Many good things did not happen because somebody decided to give up, because somebody decided to stop, because somebody decided to be diverted, to take the other road, to take the easier road, to take the lazy road. Are you hearing me this afternoon? Hallelujah, hallelujah. Now let me tell you something. You know, I'm here to tell you, you came too far to give up. You came too far to give up. Do not be like those many people. Do not be like those believers. Do not be like those Christians. Do not be like those who were in those relationships which ended prematurely. You understand what I'm saying here? You came too far. Look into your own situation. Look into your own life and look at where you are coming from. Look back and let yourself know. If it wasn't for God, then you would not have made it up to here. And if it's God who took you from the beginning, that God is able to carry on all the way to the end. You just need to stay on the bus. Do not get off that bus. The bus of your destiny, the vehicle of your destiny. Do not get back. Things may look really sad. Things may look very bad. Things may look very down. Things may look very low. But if you don't give up, if you don't stop, if you tell yourself, I came too far to give up now, I've been in this for a long time to give up now, I gotta carry on, because he who has called me, who has spoken in my life, is able to bring everything to pass in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Are we here this afternoon? Is somebody being blessed? Is somebody being blessed? Hallelujah. Zokabaya Sande Beke Shedebo. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Rambabaya Sembobo Yosika Barada Baya Sana. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we give you the praise. Father, we give you the praise. Lord, we give you the adoration. In Jesus' mighty name, there is no one like you. Nobody can compare with you. Hallelujah. When you declare, your declaration is executed in the name of Jesus. The Bible said that you call those things which are not as though they were. Yo, that's how you do. You call them by the name, and there they are manifested. You say, let there be, and let there is manifested. Let there be light, and light is manifested. Let there be breakthrough, and breakthrough is manifested. Let there be healing, and healing is manifested. You are God all by yourself. You do not change. You do not change. The power of creation is in your word. Father God, create in me a new song. Create in me a new soul. Create in me a new life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, this life which has stopped from working, create a new life in the life of this sister and brother who are watching this broadcast right now. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, if you are receiving something, shout Jesus, shout Jesus. Hallelujah. Let me carry on. There is a famous story of someone who is called Thomas Edison. Thomas Edison, he is the one who invented light bulb, fluorescent light or light bulb. He invented that. But you see, when you read the story of Thomas Edison had to try 9,999 up to even 10,000. This man tried to make or to invent light, but it did not work at the first attempt. It did not work at the second attempt. It did not work at the third, at the 100th, at the 500th, at the 1,000th. He tried, it wasn't working. But you know what? Thomas Edison, what did he do? He did not stop there. He said to himself, I have come too far to give up right now. Oh, somebody in here, God is walking. God is walking your way. God is walking your way in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Rakabaye sende boboko sika. Ri ande barada baya sande bobo. Rende beke sende bobo yosanda. Hallelujah, hallelujah. God is walking on your behalf in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thomas Edison said that I have come too far to give up. Hallelujah. And every time he finds a way that it is not working, he doesn't stop there. He doesn't give up. He said to himself, listen, I can see that now this way light bulb will not work. Let me carry on with my experiment. I'm going to talk to somebody in here. I just want to let you know, you know, when you try the first and it did not work, it doesn't mean that you are a failure. It doesn't mean that you have lost everything. It means that you learn one way how to not do it next time. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Look at the picture that you see right next to me. The picture of the frog, and this frog is being eaten by that big bird. But the frog said to itself, I am not going to give up. I'm holding the neck of this animal. I know I have to go through the neck if the animal has to eat me. So if I'm holding the neck, I am not going to give up. Therefore, the animal will give up on me. Somebody in here, your situation is like you are being swallowed. Your situation is like you are being taken away. You have been taken by the enemy. It looks like you have lost everything. It looks like you have everything that you tried. Nothing is working or nothing will ever work. But I gotta tell you something. Roke boyo soto. I gotta tell you something. There is a God. Daniel said in the book of Daniel chapter 2:28 that in heaven there is a God. Do not give up this fight. Do not give up this fight. In the mighty name of Jesus. Listen to some of the quotes from Thomas Edison. He said, I have not failed. Look at here. This man was confident. He said, I have not failed. He said, I've just found 10,000 ways that won't work. I have not failed. I just found out in these 10,000 ways, electricity is not going to work. Hallelujah. Think about this man. And then here is another quote that Thomas Edison gave. He said, genius is 1% inspiration and 99% perspiration. What does he mean? He said it's only 1%, you know, for you to be genius. All you need is a 1% of inspiration. But you also need to remember, you will need 99% of, you know, sweating. Perspiration here is talking about sweating, that you have to work hard. You do not have to give up. Do not stop. There is always a beginning to everything. Do not give up. Do not give up. Do not say to yourself that because the beginning is like this, that God is not with you. You came too far to give up. You came too far to give up. My daughter watching me right now, you came too far to give up, because sometimes you get the ideas of giving up. You get the ideas of rejecting. You get the ideas of leaving all and carry on with something else. But I'm gonna tell you something this afternoon. You came too far to give up. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Look at one more quote from Thomas Edison. He said, our greatest weakness lies in giving up. Our weakness, the biggest weakness in our life is when we are giving up. He said, our greatest weakness lies in giving up. The most certain way to succeed is always to try just one more time. This is what Thomas Edison is saying. He said, the most certain way to succeed, the best way to succeed, it is always to try one more time. That's the best way for you to succeed. So you try A, it did not work. Don't stop there. Try B. You try B, it did not work. Don't stop there. Try C. You try C, it did not work. Don't stop there. Try after C, what is it? D or whatever is coming there. Just keep on moving. Do not stop. Hallelujah. And one more quote from Thomas Edison before I carry on. He said, many of life failure are people who did not realize how close they were to succeed when they gave up. You see here, many of the life failure that we see, many things that we see that did not work, usually they are the people who did not realize that they were very close to their success and then they gave up. I just gotta tell you this afternoon, you came too far. You came too far. You came too far. Don't give up. You came too far. Child of God, don't give up. You came too far. Child of God, don't give up. You came too far. Do not give up now. You came too far. You've done a lot. You have done a lot. You have been through a lot. You came too far to give up. Do not give up. Hallelujah. Your enemies are waiting right there, expecting you to give up. That's what they are waiting for. They are waiting for you to say, okay, that's it. I don't want to do it anymore. I don't want to go there anymore. I don't want to be this anymore. That's exactly what the enemies are waiting. They are waiting for you to throw in the towel. But I gotta tell you something. Don't give up, child of God. Don't stop there, child of God. You came too far. You came too far. You came too far. God is on your side. God is with you. God is for you. God is by you. And if God be for you, no bad day can succeed against you. If God be with you, no bad day can be against you and succeed. I'm talking to you this afternoon. You were thinking about giving up or letting it go, but I'm telling you, you came too far. Look at all the investment you put in there. Your investment, you invested your time, you invested your love, you invested your finances, you invested your strength, you invested your soul, you invested your body, you invested your spirit, and now you want to give up. No, don't give up. Try it again. I said try it again. I said try it again. In the mighty name of Jesus, somebody gotta try again. Don't stop there. You came too far. Don't stop. You need to carry on in the mighty name of Jesus. Are you here this afternoon? Are you here? I need to hear people if they are here. Come on now, preach with me. Preach with me in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Look here. You see, my own experience. Let me tell you something. You know, my own experience, I dropped out of primary school. Are you hearing me? I dropped out of primary school. I dropped out of college. I dropped out of even university twice. Are you hearing me? But I said to myself, I'm not going to stop there. I'm not going to give up. Yes, it's true. I have dropped out of school. I have dropped out of college. But I will carry on. I will carry on. And I did not stop. Then I carry on and I carry on with the help of God, who has said that what he has spoken in my life will definitely come to pass. When I realized that God has a word in my life, I say, I am not going to give up. I am not going to stop. I came too far to stop. I carry on until I finish my studies and got a job that I want to do and I'm doing right now. And I give praise to God. I'm giving you my testimony to let you know, yes, there will be time when you will think like you want to give up. There will be time when everything will seem like, you know, everything is against you. But listen, these are all tests. You need to pass all the tests. You need to pass all the tests. Don't give up because you came too far. Shout Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So today, that's what I want to tell you, that you came too far to give up. Do not give up. In the book of Philippians chapter 1 verse 6, the Bible says that God who has started, you know, this good work in you is going to perform it. Hallelujah. Are you following me here? That God is going to perform it. God is going to carry on. It's not going to stop. God will carry on. God will manifest it. God will do it. Hallelujah. God will perform it. Now, this is confirming that God will not fail you. God will not fail you. God did not fail David. Before in front of Goliath, God will not fail you. God did not fail Moses in front of Pharaoh. God is not gonna fail you. God will not fail you. What he has said, he will do in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In trials, he will perform what he has said. In adversaries, he will perform what he has said to you. In opposition, he will perform what he has said to you. In every challenge, God will perform what he has said to you. Even in defeat, God will still perform what he has said to you. In lack, he will perform it. In any issue thrown at you by the enemy, God will perform what he has said to you. So you do not give up. You came too far to give up. You came too far to give up. You came too far to give up. Hallelujah. God is good. God is good. Hallelujah. God is good. If you are here this afternoon, if you see that we don't have enough viewers or something, you just share. You just share. Hallelujah. God is good. Rakabaya sande boboko sikabaya sande bebe rotebaya sanda. God is good. Hallelujah. Let's carry on. The favor of God is upon somebody in here. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Father, we give you the praise. We give you the praise. Hallelujah. I say in times of trouble, God will perform what he has said. The Bible said that he is faithful. God is faithful. It can happen sometimes we are not faithful. It can happen sometimes that we are not connected with God. It can happen sometimes that we are not there for God. But I got to tell you something. God is faithful. God is faithful. What God has started with you, that God will carry on to the fulfillment in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. God is faithful to you. He's faithful to your house. He's faithful to your wife, to your husband, to your children in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I say, do not give up. Let's go inside the Bible again in the name of Jesus. Let's go. This time, 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 24. That's what we are going to read. Hallelujah. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 24. Raka baya sendebo. Riada babaya sande bebe. 1 Thessalonians 5. Hallelujah. If you are here, go with me in the book of 1 Thessalonians 5, verse 24. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Father, we give you the praise. There is no one like you. Hallelujah. Verse 24. Verse 24. Sika baba ya sanda. Seke bobo yo soto. Hallelujah. Are you there? Are you there, child of God? The Bible says, faithful is he that calleth you. If anyone, thank you very much, Lecoq MMO. Thank you for writing the verse there. Hallelujah. If any, it says here, faithful is he that called you, who also will do it. Look at that. It says faithful. You see, it's like repeating what we've read already in the book of Philippians chapter 1 verse 6. It says here, faithful. Faithful is he that called you, who is also going to do it. God will do it. God will do it. I just want to talk to somebody. God will do it. That's what the Bible said, that he will do it. Listen, Do not shake in fear. Do not shake and tremble. Do not shake when the enemy throws anything at you. Do not be shaken. Do not be fearful, because God is faithful and He is going to do it. Whatever He has spoken in your life, whatever He has spoken over you, whatever He has said about your case, my God is going to do it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let me show you another verse. In the book of Ephesians chapter 6 verse 13, let me find it. Hallelujah. Roka baya sanda ria de bobo risaka baya sende bobo kosia na baya sende rende beke sia na baya sa randa baba yese koboyo soto. Hallelujah, hallelujah, sata. Hallelujah. Look at here. I just want to show you the last part of the verse. If you look at the broadcast, you can see the one that I highlighted. Hallelujah. The Bible say in verse 13, the Bible say, wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day. Hallelujah. And he carry on and say, and having done all to stand. What he's trying to say here, he's trying to say, when you are going through all the issue, and then you are overcoming, and then you overcoming here, you need to keep standing. You need to keep standing in the realm of the spirit, meaning that you need not to give up. Hallelujah. You need to carry on, because you are coming from far. You are coming from far. You've burned so many times. You've been through many fires and many waters and many valleys and many mountains. Do not give up. You need to keep on standing, because the God who has called you, He's faithful and is going to bring it to pass what He told you is going to do. If you don't give up, if you don't give up, child of God, you are here. Do not give up. Do not give up the fight. That's what I gotta tell you. Don't give up the fight in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Do not stop there. Do not give up. Don't say to yourself that I am not going to do it, that it's not going to happen, that God has spoken but it's not working. Hallelujah. Don't say that to yourself. I said don't give up. Child of God, don't give up. You need to carry on. 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 Maybe somebody who had a miscarriage, you lost your baby, and now you are going to give up. You are so tired, you don't want to carry on. Listen, you need to carry on. Don't give up, child of God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Don't give up Lecoq MMO. Don't give up Shelly Ann. Don't give up Anta Mireille. Don't give up McAvoy Z. Don't give up Louise. Don't give up. Don't give up on the fight. Listen, God relies on you to win this battle. Even though God has overcome the battle, you need to stand and hold the medal in your hand in the mighty name of Jesus. So no matter what it is, don't give up, my brother Sandy. Don't give up, my brother Dennis. Don't give up, my sister who is watching me, living word. Do not give up the fight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sometimes it looks like God has forgotten us. It looks like God has rejected us. But do not give up. You came too far. Don't give up. You came too far. You came too far. Hallelujah. Many people went through the same issue and they came out in a different way. But your way is going to be different. I say your outcome shall be different. Because if God be for you, your face is going to shine in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. If God be for you, there will be a smile in your face. Every sadness that has been able to manifest themselves in your life all this time, my God will replace them with a smile in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let me tell you something. Sometimes we give up so early. Look at here. Elijah said to his servant, he told his servant, I want you to go and check. Go and check if there is a cloud in the sky, and you will come here to confirm, because that cloud means that there is rain coming. After 3 years, 6 months, there was not rain, and Elijah prophesied that there is going to be rain. But then here, a servant of the man of God could not see what was happening. In the book of 1 Kings chapter 15 verse 43, hallelujah. Let me just send you the reference in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, hallelujah. In the book of 1 Kings chapter 15 verse 43. Now the servant of the man of God went. He could not see the cloud. He came to Elijah and he said to Elijah, listen, I cannot see the clouds. So Elijah said to him, go again. So he went again. He looked everywhere. He was trying to find the cloud, the little cloud he was looking for. He could not find the cloud. He came to Elijah. Then Elijah said to him again, go and check. Somebody in here, God is sending you once and twice and three times and four times. Listen, don't give up. It is something that has happened before. We've seen this before in the Bible. Like I'm telling you in the First Kings chapter 15, verse 43. Look at here. It has happened before. Elijah said to his servant, go again. He went, nothing was there. Now Elijah did not give up. Elijah did not say, okay, now this is the fourth time that this man is going, but he's not seeing anything, he's not finding anything, let's forget about it, there is not going to be rain. Elijah did not say that. Elijah was sure of himself. I want to tell you, be sure of yourself, because God in you, Christ in you, the hope of glory, it is not you who is living anymore, but it's Christ living in you, because your past life is dead and is gone. The new life you have right now is the life of the Son of God inside of you. So let me tell you something, be sure of yourself. Elijah was so sure of himself, and he said, listen, go again. And the servant went. When he went there for the last time, I think that was the seventh time, he found the cloud that he was looking for. Then he came running. He came to the master. He said, Elijah, listen, I saw the cloud, but it looks very small, very tiny. I saw the cloud. Are you hearing me? Somebody in here, let me tell you something. There is a light at the end of the tunnel that you are going through. There is a light at the end of the tunnel that your family has been going through. And the light is the broad daylight coming up. It's not another train coming in the opposite direction. It is the broad light of God, the light of salvation. There is a light in the tunnel that your family, your four family, your four family have been in that tunnel for years and generation over generation. But you are coming out by fire, by thunder, because you've been there, you came, you did not see anything. You went there, you came, you did not see anything. But this time, go, and you will see your cloud, just like what happened to Elijah in 1 Kings 15. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Somebody is receiving the deliverance in the mighty name of Jesus. Somebody is receiving their breakthrough. Listen, let me tell you, you will have a lot of adversaries. You will have a lot of opposers. You will have people opposing you. People being adverse, people being against you, people being against your success because of just jealousy, because of I don't know what. There will be people standing against you. There will be people trying to reject. There will be people trying to say things about you. But don't worry, it is not them who called you. It is not in them you have put your faith. You put your faith in the Lord God of Israel, and that God will not give up on you. That God will not reject you. That God will not refuse you. That God will not forget about you. He has promised to you he's gonna bring it to pass, because he stands by his word all the way to the fulfillment of that word. If you receive, shout Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Sekabaya Santa. Am I talking to somebody in here this afternoon? Hallelujah, hallelujah. There are some people that I don't see here. Hallelujah. Rokabaya Sanda. Somebody in here, don't give up. I say you have come too far. Woman of God, Prophetess Julia, thank you for coming to support us. Hallelujah. I really appreciate Baba Sanda. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Somebody shout Jesus. Come on, let me carry on. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Do not stop there. Do not give up. Do not give up in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let me tell you about a story of someone. There was this woman. This woman, she was losing blood. That's how we know her in the Bible, in the book of Mark chapter 5. We call her the woman with the issue of blood. She was losing blood, and that was the sickness she had. Now she said to herself that I have heard that Jesus is coming in town, and then amen, if I can touch Jesus Christ, I am going to receive my healing. Now, when Jesus came in town, hallelujah, hallelujah, God is good. Now, when Jesus came in town, this woman went behind Jesus, and then she tried to touch Jesus. I want you to follow this carefully. She tried to touch Jesus. Now, look at what's happening here. Every time she tried to touch Jesus, the disciples of the Lord will push her. Every time she tried to touch the garment of Jesus, the apostle will reject her. Every time she tried to touch Jesus, the people that she put her trust in, they all push her away. The crowd will push her away. The people were stepping on her fingers, and she could not do anything. She was stuck. She was blocked. She was being stepped on. But listen what she said. She said, I am not going to give up. I came too far to give up. Look at here. She had to hide herself away from the city. Because in Israel, if you have that kind of disease, then you cannot go among the people. So the woman said to herself, I have already come among the people. I am already in the midst of people. So I came too far. I can't go back in my house the way I came in. I'm here. I got to get healed today or I die today. Trying to get my healing. The woman did not give up. She said to herself, I came too far. I came too far. This thing I have started. Yes, it is true. The beginning did not work. The middle is not working. But I know the end is going to be positive. I know the end is going to be positive. I'm talking to somebody in here this afternoon. The end of your story is going to be different. Because my Father God, Jehovah El Shaddai, is changing your situation this afternoon. He's changing your situation this afternoon. God is giving you another way of going about your situation. God is giving you another strategy in this afternoon in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You came too far to give up. You came too far to give up. You started a business and the business is looking like, oh, it's not going to work. Listen, don't give up. You know, the fact that you started already, there is a God. God is putting angels in position in order to serve you. Angels are being positioned in order to work for you, in order to fight for you. So if you give up, these angels will not have any work to do. So do not give up. You need to stand there. God will provide the provision because his name is Jehovah Jireh, the provider of the provision in every situation. So you do not give up. The people around you, the people, the enemy, they will be tired and they are going to give up. If you believe with that, just shout Jesus, shout Jesus, shout Jesus. This woman did not give up. She said that I'm not going to stop there. It may look like things are not going the way I planned the thing. When I left my country, I came in this country, I said to myself, by so-so year, by so-so age, I'm going to be able to have this. I'm going to be able to do this. I'm going to be able to possess this. But then it's not working. These things did not happen. That it looked like your life is late. It looks like your life is being delayed. It looks like your life has been diverted. It looks like everything is that you work for, everything you plan, all is going down. That's what it looks like. Hey, 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 can I talk to somebody in here? If God is with you, that God will do it. Is that not what we read today in all these Bible verses? He who made that promise is able to keep it. If he said that, my son, you're my son, my daughter, you are going to make it, you need to believe it because the word of God is a rock. And if you stand on it, you will see the fulfillment in your life by fire, by thunder, in the name of Jesus. Papa God, put a smile in the face of that young man. Put a smile in the face of that young woman in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I'm not gonna give up. I'm not gonna give up. If a woman, this woman in the Bible, she was sick. She did not have any more energy. She was not strong anymore. Everything, it was really hard for her, but she did not give up. How dare you give up? You came too far. Come on now. I want you to look back. Look where you are coming from. Look where you are coming from. Look back behind you. You came too far to give up today. You came too far to say that, okay, I have had enough. No, you came too far. Do not give up. By fire, by thunder, Holy Ghost, fire on you wherever you are right now. Let the fire of the Holy Ghost visit you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Holy Ghost, visit your people. Holy Ghost, visit your children in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Don't give up. The woman did not give up. And we know the story of this woman now. What happened to her? That disease she had, that incurable disease which was in her body, that disease disappeared straight away. And the Bible speaks about that woman when she touched Jesus. Jesus has never been touched in that way. Are you hearing me? It's not like she budged him or she pushed him, but she touched Jesus with the power and the touch of faith. Hallelujah. And Jesus said, a power, a strength, energy came out of me. That's what's going to happen. When you don't give up, you will draw energy out of God. When you don't give up, you will draw power out of Jesus. When you don't give up, you will draw favor out of God. And he will position the angels in your situation in order to help you make it in your situation. In Jesus' mighty name. Are you here? Some people give up early. Like I said earlier, Thomas Edison, he said, what did he say? He said that the greatest failure or something like that, hallelujah. He said many of life's failures are people who did not realize that they were close, one step close to their breakthrough. Some people, they are one step close to their breakthrough and they mess up the whole thing. Let me tell you something. A woman will start having belly ache and belly this and belly that. A pregnant woman will start having belly ache when the baby is about to come out. Are you hearing me here? So when you see things are not really, really working the way they should be working, your baby is not far. The baby is coming out very soon. So if you give up, it's like giving up on the last step. Hallelujah. And then you will fail. Do not fail. It's coming your way. What God has said, what God has declared, what God has planned is coming your way in the mighty name of Jesus. If you give up before the destination, what's going to happen? Let me tell you something. There's a story in the Bible. In the book of Daniel, Daniel prayed for the translation and interpretation of the dream. Now, God sent the translation and the interpretation of the dream at the same time Daniel prayed. But when the answer was coming, the answer was blocked on the way. The answer was stopped on the way. Daniel started praying. Day one, he prayed. He did not see the answer. Day two, he prayed. He did not see the answer. Day three, he prayed. He did not see the answer. Day 15, he prayed. He did not see the answer. Day 19, he prayed. He did not see the answer. Day 20, he prayed. He did not see the answer. Daniel did not stop. He went to pray again one more day. He prayed on the day 21. After the day 21, the answer that he was looking for was manifested. Now think about if Daniel was to stop at the day 20. Think about if Daniel was to stop at the day 18. Think about if Daniel was to stop at the day 13. Will he have seen the breakthrough? No. Many of us, we go through failure because we stop at day 15. We stop at day 10. We stop at day 9. We stop at day. Many of us can even go up to day 20. We stop there and then we don't see the breakthrough. Hallelujah. I want you to understand, I'm speaking with symbols. It doesn't have to be day 20, day 21, day 25, but I'm just saying, you don't stop until you see what God has planned for you. You don't stop until you possess your possession. You don't stop until you get your getting. You don't stop until you have your hand on that thing that you've been looking for in the mighty name of Jesus. Shout amen, shout amen, shout amen. Somebody shout amen. If you are blessed this afternoon, shout amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Are you there? Are you there? Hallelujah. If you haven't shared our live video, then you know you have to share them. Hallelujah. Zokababaya sana. Yeboko so de bako se de bebebe. Welcome, Didi Love. Welcome, Florian, Vanessa. Welcome, Suzanne. Suzanne, yes, you are blessed. You are blessed. You are blessed, Shelian. You are blessed. Hallelujah. Louise Azu, you are blessed. You are blessed. Sandy Kaba, you are blessed. In the mighty name of Jesus. Rokabaya sende bobo. Rienaba, living word, you are blessed. In the name of Jesus. If anyone here is online and I haven't called your name, maybe haven't seen it yet. It went quickly through. I haven't seen it. You can bring a word like amen. I can see your name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Rakabaya sende boko sika bararabaya sanda. Hallelujah. Cynthia C, you are blessed. In the mighty name of Jesus. Suzanne, Suzanne, you are blessed. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Sandi Kaba, my brother, you are blessed. Oh, Kadiatu Kamara, you are blessed. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let the favor of God locate you wherever you are. Let the favor locate you wherever you are. I say favor. You see, this is the beginning of a new week. I call upon the favor of God to locate you where you are. In the mighty name of Jesus. I'm talking to somebody. You have come too far to give up now. Suzanne Akapo, you have come too far to give up now. Don't give up this fight. Hallelujah. Let me tell you something. You are not alone in the fight. Let me tell you, you've got the best army in this fight. You got the good people on your side. You have the Davids on your side. You have the Moses on your side. You have the Jeremiahs on your side. You have the Isaiahs on your side. You have the Abraham on your side. So let me tell you something. Your army is dangerous. And above that, you've got the whole army of heaven on your side. Do you think you are going to lose this battle? Do you think you are going to lose the battle? No. By default, you are coming out as the winner. Just like David. David, physically talking, could not defeat Goliath. We all know that. But it is God. If that God is with you, if that God is on your side, if that God is by you, then by default, you will come out. You will come out with your head up in the mighty name of Jesus. Shout Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Zekabaya Sada. I'm going to give you one more quick story in the Bible. Let me tell you, there was a story of this woman. I love the story so much because every message you preach, that story will come in. This woman was Anna. Anna was in a polygamous home. Anna was in a house where she was mistreated. Anna was in a house where she was insulted just because she could not have baby. Just because she could not have baby. She was barren, she could not have baby. And because of that, the enemy used that to threaten her. You know what? Now, the Bible says something in the book of 1 Samuel. The Bible says that Anna was going to Shiloh every year when the husband was going to make a special service unto the Lord. Anna will go with the husband. And she goes there so she can present her case to the Lord. And she goes to the Lord and she says, oh, my father, look at their servant. Oh, God, help me. She went there once. It did not work. She went there twice. It did not work. You know, she could have said, let me give up. Hallelujah. But she said to herself, I have come too far to give up. This time, I am not going to stop. Penina is on my case. That was her rival in the same polygamous house. Penina is on my case. If I give up now, Penina is not going to sleep. She is going to be insulting me. She is going to be mocking me. So I'm not giving up the fight. She kept on going. She kept on going. She kept on going until she went for the last time, just like the prayer of Daniel on the 21st day. Hallelujah. Until the last time she went, and then boom, the barren woman became a mother. I'm talking to somebody in here. What is impossible to people is possible to the children of God. The barren woman became a mother, and so shall be your situation. Your poverty shall become your riches. I'm talking to somebody in here. That sickness which has been put your way will become a total health restoration for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Shout amen. Shout amen. Hallelujah. Rekabaya Sanda. Somebody is receiving something in here in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Like I told you, my own experience earlier, said to you, I have failed in many, many, in many places, but I never give up. You know, I don't share when I fail something. I don't share it because I do not propagate or amplify if it happened that I failed. Or can I say if it happened that it did not work for me? I don't say. You know me, those of you who have been with me for long, I don't share it. I share the glory and the power of God. And then when the testimony comes, I refer to when I tried in the past and it did not work. And I told you earlier that I dropped out in primary school, in college, in university, more than even twice. Hallelujah. But then I did not stop there. And you can do it, and you can do better than what I did. So it doesn't matter if you fail 10 times in a marriage, or you fail 10 times in your workplace, or you fail 10 times in your studies. Don't worry. You keep on going. God is by you. And because you have come too far, you're not going to give up. My God will make a way for you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You came too far to give up, my sister. You came too far to give up, my brother. When you are dismissed, when you drop out of anything, when you fail to achieve many goals that you have planned to achieve, you know, it looks like all is impossible. It looks like nothing is going to work for you. But listen to me this afternoon. Do not give up. You came too far to give up. Hallelujah. Let me pray for you. Father God, we give you the praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You came too far to give up. We give you the praise, Father God. Hallelujah. Somebody is blessed this afternoon. Hallelujah. If you are blessed this afternoon, shout amen wherever you are in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that God give you a testimony in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Where you are, may our Father God give you a testimony in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we give you the praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We give you all the adoration. We worship you. We worship you, Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I pray for your people. I pray for your children. Father God, may you touch the life of Suzanne. May you touch the life of Evangelist Makabwazi. May you touch the life of Louise Azu. May you touch the life of Sandy Kaba in the mighty name of Jesus. Father God, touch the life of Anta Mireille as she's following as well, watching. Lord God, touch the life of Minister Florian Vanessa, touch the life of Suzanne Akapo in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father God, touch the life of Living Word in the name of Jesus. Give her a testimony. Give a testimony to Lecoq MMO. Father God, this new week that has begun, let your favor be manifested in the lives of your children. I'm talking about Didi Godlove. In the name of Jesus, receive the visit of the Lord right now, where you are, in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Father God, your favor in the life of Kadiatu in her house. Let your light shine in there. Let the light of God by fire shine in that place right now in Jesus' mighty name. A testimony in the lives of your people. Father God, some of those who were going to give up, who were going to let go, Lord God, I give you the praise because right now you have assured them that you are still with them, that you are still in their house, that you are still in the case, in the situation. And because you are in the situation, you are going to make sure that they make it in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You are blessed this afternoon, child of God. We are toward the end of our service. Hallelujah. May the favor continue to locate you in Jesus' mighty name. Lord, we give you the praise. We cover this message with the blood of Jesus. Anyone online who wants to pray for the message, you can do it. You can write the comment, you know, like what we do in the church. After a message, we can preach. Hallelujah. I mean, pray for the message, so that the people who receive the message can be covered and the message be covered with the blood of Jesus in their life. Anyone who wants to do that online, you can do it. I know Pastor Alma is we can't see her, even though she's online. She can see everything, all the comments we are putting there. The pastor can see all the comments, but we can't see her. You are blessed. You are blessed, Pastor. You are blessed. Hallelujah. So anyone who wants to send in a prayer for the message, the person is welcome. But otherwise, I pray that everything we learn today be covered with the blood of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus, let all be covered with the blood of Jesus. May you not forget what you learned today. May you not forget what you learned today. You are not going to give up. You are not going to give up, child of God. No, you are not going to give up. The devil is a liar. The devil has lost this battle in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we give you the praise in Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. If you want to be born again, if you are not born again, you are a new person to the Lord. You want to maybe renew your connection with God. You can do this prayer with me. Hallelujah. Pray with me for your new birth. Hallelujah. Dear Jesus Christ, I repent from my sins. I come before you in order for you to come in my life. Hallelujah. Come in my life. I accept you as my Lord and Savior. Come and live in me. Hallelujah. If you've done that prayer, then you are born again. Hallelujah. Find a church where the word of God is preached. Go and become a member. I'm talking about a real born again member. Hallelujah. If you are part of our church, the New Dimension Ministries, then the address is on the screen. You can call us. You can come to the church when all the church services are open and we can have service together. Hallelujah. We preach the word of God. We have worship. We have deliverance prayers and all these on the menu. Hallelujah. So you can come and join us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Someone in here, you want to sow seed, you want to help, all the details are on the screen. Hallelujah. The church buildings may have been closed by the government, but we are still here. So if you want to sow, you are blessed. Hallelujah. The church account details are there. You can do PayPal. You can do bank transfer. Anyhow you want to do it, it will always come in for the furtherness of the ministry of the house of God. Hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise. We give you the praise. Someone is blessed. Hallelujah. As you are going this afternoon, in the name of Jesus Christ, let you avoid every accident that was heading your way. May you avoid them in the name of Jesus Christ. The accident shall not see you. The accident shall not see your children. The accident shall not see your people in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. As you are going, let your week be blessed. Your week be covered with the blood of Jesus Christ. Let this week be a week of revival for you and your household in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your husband, what you expect you from your husband, may that thing work this week. May you see the hand of God in that thing, in your husband's life, in your wife's life, in your children's life, in this week, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father God, we give you the glory. We give you the adoration. Hallelujah. There's no one like you. Hallelujah. You are blessed, child of God. Our service is actually over now. We're finishing our program is finished now because it's a Sunday service, so we don't stay for long. Hallelujah. So we actually stay for about an hour, amen, because there's no worship time and this, but the church is going to be open very soon, and we are going to see all this stuff in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You are blessed, child of God. Have a wonderful Sunday. I love you guys very much and stay blessed. Bye-bye and bye-bye. Bye. Stay blessed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
bless me, O Father. Now I dance like a widow man.
I will praise you, Lord, for your grace on my life. You have blessed me, O Father. Now I dance like a widow man.
When you see me dance, I dance like a widow man. I step like a winner man.
When you see me dance, I dance like a winner
Sorry.
Man.
Oh, 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 winner man.
Oh, 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 winner man.
Oh, oh, winner man.
Oh, oh, winner man.
Say, oh, oh, winner man.
Oh, oh, winner man.
Say, oh, oh, winner man.
Oh, oh, winner man.
Say, oh, oh, winner man. Are you a winner? Are you a winner?
Oh,